Hey everybody, welcome back to A Better Computer. My name is Matt, and today I want to show you how I created this plugin called Ghosty Posty, which is an Obsidian plugin that lets you post to your Ghost blog from Obsidian Notes, right? And so I made it, I've been using it for a couple days myself. I wrote it in one day, and I am currently waiting for it to be reviewed by human to get into the community plugins, right? So that's if you go to Obsidian, go to Settings, and then Community Plugins. You can browse, and it will eventually show up here when you search for Ghosty Posty. I want to show you how it works. I want to show you how I made it, and I want to really just like emphasize this is what I really love about these AI-powered code editors, large language model-powered code editors, whatever word you want to use. They really are useful for letting people create things that I've wanted to exist in the world for a long time. I've wanted this for years. I've wanted to publish to my Ghost blog from Obsidian for a long time, and I haven't been able to do it because there wasn't a plugin that existed that did what I wanted. And I was able to just sit down for a couple hours and make it happen, and that's super awesome. Like, the fact that I'm potentially going to be able to distribute it to everyone who wants to use it, that's even better. But like, I solved my own problem with code, with help from these assistants, and I think that's really awesome. So let's go ahead and see what I built. So here's a potential blog post that I want to put on my site. And how would I publish this? Well, first, let's go ahead and go to the settings in the app. And you can see down here we have the community plugin for Ghosty Posty. If I go into that, here are all the settings for it. Basically, you give us your homepage, so the URL for your blog, your admin key. If you don't know how to get that and you're looking at this for a bit of a tutorial, basically you sign into your Ghost admin, go to settings, scroll all the way down. There's an integration section here, and then you add a custom integration. We're going to go ahead and do this, and we'll call this test for video. Add it. And then you get this admin API key, copy this to your clipboard, and then paste it into the app. Easy enough. We're going to go ahead and close that. We're actually going to delete this one because don't want that one to be available. But yeah, so then you paste it into here. You can give us an images directory. So if you want to upload images with your posts as well, you just tell us what directory in Obsidian they're going to be in. Mine is in the directory assets/files. You can open the editor after publish. We are going to do that to prove that it's working. And then you can enable recent posts, which lets you basically have a consistent document with your 20 most recent blog posts if you want quick links to those. That can be useful, may not, but for me, I really like this. And then once everything's plugged in, you can test your connection and looks like we're good. So that's really it. Let's use this post as an example. So it's basically a title. Here's who wrote it. Here's a link to the thing. Here's a block quote. And then an image embedded here and everything. So like this image is called this and it's in my files directory, right? So let's go ahead and hit Command P to bring up the command bar. I actually have it pinned already, but Ghosty Posty is here. If we select that, it's going to go ahead and upload this image file to Ghost. It's going to take a second there. So if you have a post with images, it's going to take a couple seconds to upload it. If it's just text, it's going to be instant. But yeah, so you get a couple things here at the top and then a preview of what the blog post is going to look like. This image is huge, so I probably need to shrink this down a little bit, but that's doable. You can set the status to draft, published, or schedule for later. If you do schedule for later, a time picker comes up. This is in your local time zone. We'll just do a draft for now. Visibility can be everyone, all members, or paid members only. We'll make this one available for everyone. You can make it a featured post or not, and you can add tags. So we'll do this as my links tag. Let's also do gaming, how about, as another tag, just to show you that multiple tags work. And once I'm good with it, let's go ahead and publish. And so this takes just a moment. We see the Gen Z powered retro gaming revival. Here's exactly what the note looked like, links and everything. The image is here. This is a native image and everything for Ghost. And if I go ahead over here, you should see links and gaming as tags. It's public and it is only a draft. So I'm going to go ahead and delete this because we don't need this anymore. But it totally works, and that's really, really awesome. Let me try this again. Let's go to Ghosty Posty. It's going to upload the image again. I don't really have the ability to check if the image is already uploaded to your site, so we are getting duplicates here. Let's schedule this one for later. Let's do this at 9 a.m. local time, and we'll do links again as the tag. Go ahead and publish. And now this should, if I actually clicked publish, oh, I didn't actually click it. There we go. It's scheduled to be published at 9 a.m. tomorrow. Oh, yeah. It defaults to tomorrow, I think. So I need to potentially update that. But yeah, 9 a.m. tomorrow it would go up, just proving that scheduled posts work as well. So that's what it is. I think it's really, really nice. For me, it satisfies all my needs. It could probably be made better. It could probably be expanded with more features. Oh, and then the recents post, by the way, is here's all my recent posts. And I could just go to Meta has squandered threads. There you go. I've got a quick access to my recent blog posts. So this is kind of nice. Again, you don't need to use this, but I kind of like it. But how did we make this? How did this happen? How did this come into being? And I'll show you in Cursor basically how this happened. I'm not going to show you every single request, but I'm going to show you and give you an idea for what sort of requests got me here. So I started by just creating an empty folder on my Mac, opening that folder in Cursor, and that's where I started. So I said this is a mostly empty Obsidian plugin that is supposed to let users publish their Obsidian notes to their Ghost blogs as posts. Can you make this a plugin that lets the user enter their website URL and relevant API key when they put this into the plugin prefs, validate them so the user knows that they're valid? So we saw that when we tested the connection. Don't do anything else. We'll do this later. I don't want to make it too complicated and be as simple as possible. So I have found occasionally, if you just tell it to do something very vaguely, it will get too creative and do too much. So I sometimes will remind it to keep it simple, because it will get a little crazy. By the way, I have NPM installed for an Obsidian plugin. I think it's required. I believe you need NPM installed to kind of build the project, but basically I told it I do have NPM installed and can install dependencies, keep it as simple as possible with as few third-party code as I can. Keep an eye out for cores issues. This is because I was noticing when I was doing some testing ahead of time that uploading or making the connection would sometimes trigger a cores issue because you're technically in a web browser environment in Electron apps. So keep an eye out for that. I'm on the Ghost V5 API version and make sure to include some logging so I can see what's going wrong, because it will not just work right out of the box. You're going to have to work with it and have it figure things out. So I like to have logging to make sure I can see what's going wrong, what requests are being made, and that helps me kind of troubleshoot this as it goes. So it's doing its thing. It's finding the things in the directory. It's writing the package, JSON, manifest, which are required for Obsidian. It's doing the build rules. And yeah, it's kind of just doing a lot in this first step to get everything up and running. You can see it's running into linter errors, so it's fixing them. Now we need to install the dependencies. So it will ask you. You can have it auto run these, but I have it ask me for confirmation right now for these pretty much all the time, where it will install the NPM dependencies. And great. Okay, so it's done. I've kind of walked through this again. It's going to explain to you what it did. And now I have other issues. Hey, I'm still getting cores issues. And then I paste in kind of the error. This is an Electron app, if that helps. So it makes some changes. It's trying to fix that. It says it's fixed, and then I say, okay, progress. So now it says resource not found. It's not a valid URL we're hitting, so we can try to fix this, or at least add logging to see what we're hitting. So again, logging is very, very helpful for this, so that I can see in the logs. Oh, by the way, if you are building an Obsidian plugin and want to see the logs, Command Option I will bring up the console, the developer tools with the console pulled up, so you can see your console logs there. So super, super helpful when you're developing a plugin. So it's going to do its thing, remove the V5 from the URLs. So that was the issue. Once I saw the login, I saw we were posting to this URL that just didn't exist. So they got rid of that. Okay, it seems to be working. Now let's add an option to the command palette that lets the user post their current note. And so that's where we got to the point where in Obsidian, you can hit Command P and Ghosty Posty appears as an option, right? And so there we go. It's doing all this stuff. I got an error. Sometimes that's all you need to tell it. Still getting this. So you feed it back its error codes to it. So fix it and add some logging. And so this kind of just, we kind of go through this whole thing. There's an issue generating a valid JWT. And so you can kind of see the process here is I just kind of tell it to do something. It either does it successfully or there's errors. I tell it what the errors are. I try to add logging so I can see the errors. Maybe I can Google the error and try to understand it so I can tell it, here's what's going on, here's what is wrong, and here's how you fix it. And then that can really help it. And now we kind of got to the point where this is only a couple prompts in. Let's start parsing the post data and figuring out what to do. So I'm telling it there's going to be front matter. I didn't have front matter in my post, but it will support it. It does support it, I should say, where you can put tags, the status, the time, basically everything in that pop-up. Basically everything in, we're going to get rid of the image so we can do this quicker. Basically everything in this top section you can include as front matter. So actually if I go to archive, here we go. You can kind of see I have tags and status on this one, tag status and time on this one. So I have been using that a little bit. But yeah, you can do these if you'd like. And then, yeah, so it's kind of doing its thing. I was doing test posts. I was seeing what was working. I was seeing what wasn't working. And I just kind of go through this and iterate and iterate and iterate. And again, the best advice I can give people trying this for themselves is to start simple, build the simplest thing possible, right? And then build from there. So again, when I started, I don't have a screenshot of it or anything, but like, after that initial request where I said, this is an empty folder, it's going to be an Obsidian plugin, all I want you to do is ask for a URL, an API key, and we're going to use Ghost API to validate the connection. It was just this first field, the second field, and a test button. That was it. Once I got that test button to work and I was able to see in the console logs that it was actually posting to my site and getting a valid success, then I moved on to, okay, let's add more to it. Let's let a command palette thing exist. Let's just keep adding features one at a time. You don't just go in and say, let's build the entire plugin. Here's everything it's going to do. It's too much. It's going to get more, it's going to get closer than you might think, but there's going to be issues. There's going to be weird things. And just like writing regular code, which again, I know enough code to be dangerous in a couple areas, but I'm not an Obsidian plugin creator. I don't know how to do that. And so, yeah, this was all new to me, but like just being able to go in step by step, doing one thing at a time, not getting too crazy, not biting off the entire project in one request. That's really, really helpful to just kind of do things one at a time, make small changes, test them, make sure they work, make sure you don't have regressions, and just carrying on from there and building it out. It's a new, interesting way to develop software. And again, if I got much more complicated than this, this would start to get out of hand. I would start to lose track of like what's going on, how everything's working together and everything. Bugs would be more likely to happen. But as long as I stop relatively soon, I should have something that's totally usable and totally useful for hopefully more people out there than just me. So yeah, that's it. I think this is a really cool way to make these little utilities that are useful to you personally. I think a similar version of this was Apple Shortcuts, which came out many years ago and is, I think, really awesome. But this is a new way to kind of build that stuff for yourself without having to wait for other people to do it. So thank you so much for watching. Hope this was helpful. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.